Aloha, welcome to Live Yoga Channel. I am Tara, the metabolic therapist, and today it's Wellness Wednesday, and I appreciate you tuning in to the Trust Your Gut Club. We meet here each Wednesday and we talk stories, so please, if you have any questions, feel free to write them in the chat box. I'll do my best to answer. And we love to share in recipes, do-it-yourself, home health care, and inspiration, because as something that I've learned through my life is that diet and lifestyle very much is a spiritual path. So I love to share with you. Maybe you've talked with me before or seen how fortunate I've been blessed by the nourishment of bone broth. And so I went on a ketogenic therapy back in 2017 because I was having some major issues with my nervous system. And it was a big deal because I was this very rigid raw vegan and believed that, aloha, Melissa. Yes, I believed that, you know, that was the way, but it was high carb, low fat, or high fat too, but it was causing all sorts of metabolic dysfunction and it led to some nervous system issues. So I've had to change lots in my life. And first thing was I started drinking bone broth, and what a healing experience. I mean, I had to make peace with the food chain. And as I did that, I'll always remember that first sip of broth and just feeling how nourishing it felt. And of course it reminded me of, you know, maybe some chicken soup that grandma made back when I was a kid. Yet from there on, I made a commitment to invite and welcome animal nourishment back into my life and stay committed to getting well-sourced, ethically treated animals for my body and care. So what I'd love to do today, maybe you've heard me say or others have said, oh yeah, just drink some bone broth. What does that even mean? And there's all sorts that you can buy at the store these days. And so I want to talk about that, because all brands, I wouldn't say, are created equal. And so you might find a price point that's right for you, a brand that's right for you. And let's talk about best ways to get in the bone broth nutrition. So please, as best as you can, go for grass-fed, grass-finished, organic. Talk to the person that made the broth. Often there's somebody in your neighborhood that's making it that you might be able to get it from. Otherwise, there's lots of great companies, especially on the mainland. If you're in mainland U.S., also Good Bones. They send incredible nourishment straight to your door. They have great prices. There's also another brand, Kettle and Fire. You can get at Whole Foods. I've also seen them at Safeway and their little boxes. And so for years, because it took me a few years before I started making my own, I would purchase, others' bone broth, and it still gave me a lot of relief. And what it is the broth is it's high in calcium, magnesium, and minerals and collagens that's drawn from the bones. And this is epigenetic nutrition. This is ancestral eating and soothing. And so what it does is it soothes our digestive tract from the mouth all the way down to the anus. And so a lot of us have compromised immunity, you know, and so I've learned to thrive, and I feel poised for this time in the world, you know, give thanks that I am learning to thrive with a compromised immune system. How do I best take care of my body so that I feel good? And there's a lot of pathogens out there or things that can cause flare-ups. So how do I best take care of myself? And that's very much through nutrition and lifestyle. Sleep hygiene is really important. Without me getting sidetracked, what I want to do is share with you. Okay, so this is the bone broth that I'm pulling out of my fridge. Now in here, maybe you can see there's a gel-like to it. Now, I would say even after making it for a few years, not every batch has the same consistency of gel, and that depends on the bones and things that you're using, but it doesn't mean that it's not still full of rich collagen. So if you buy it at the store, if you get it at the store or make it at home, there is going to be some need for you to test it out and see how you prefer it. And that may change over time too. Like how I'm drinking it today was not how I was 5 years ago when I first started. So what I do is I pack myself a thermos, and a Stanley thermos or a thermos, not a hydro flask, although I can appreciate a hydro flask. They don't really keep as warm. And so I make myself a thermos because this is what I use throughout my afternoon. It serves with me, and when I'm in between meetings, instead of snacks or an extra cup of coffee in the afternoon, like sugar snacks that you know, just keep me like feeling like I need to keep eating sugar. I snack and nourish myself on broth in the afternoon. And so I like to have a full thermos with me. However, there's other times where I don't need as much. And so, you know, if you're new and you want to just, you know, get started, you know, find something that keeps things warm and that can serve for you to travel with you. And what I'm going to show you is how it works with my broth is I do a one-to-one. So that's what I suggest is a great way to start. You know, so one-to-one means I take this, I call this the bone broth concentrate. There we go. All right. So I'm going to pour this into here. I am the best pourer ever. And on the top of mine, there's some tallow. It's some fat that I love to use when I'm roasting vegetables and making eggs. Okay, so I filled it halfway with the broth concentrate. And then as easy as taking, I heated some kettle water and then pour it in here. So top it off with kettle water. That's like the easiest way to prepare it for me. Now, if something should happen and I don't drink all of this and I come home with some, I can pour it in a jar and then pull it out tomorrow and reheat it on the stove on low, and then drink it. So there's a few ways, but this way serves for ease. Put the lid on. But what I suggest you do is taste it to try, because sometimes each batch is a little bit different. So I'm going to taste here. Oh, so good. Now I'm wanting a little bit more salt. So salt, you know, to taste. Now I'm a big, big fan of salt because our body, all of our functions and our cells need sodium. So good salt though. And I'm a big fan of Himalayan pink salt as well as Celtic sea salt. Now this is a super rich, flavorful, called black salt. You can get this at Indian stores. I find an organic version from the Himalayas on Amazon. And then I can add that if I'm wanting a little bit more rich flavor in terms of salt. And then vital proteins. I'm a fan of these collagen peptides. They don't have flavor to them, and they are from a reputable company in New Zealand that is several generations family farm, and they treat their animals well. That's really important to me. So best prices at Costco. I'm not sponsored by any of these brands that I'm promoting today, although I don't mind being sponsored by them. So go ahead and add 2 scoops. And what the collagen does is it helps to add amino acids to the soup, and it helps even more so with satiety. So it's serving. It really works as a great afternoon bevy. So shake it up. And then it's just available. So when you're ready for your afternoon break, you can pour yourself some. Oh yeah, that's good. Savory, rich, soothing. It's very grounding. This is a venison broth from some friends that brought back the bones from a hunting trip on Molokai, which is a neighbor island here in Hawaii. And so I feel so grateful to be that connected. So the venison is part of the sustainable food chain that we do have here in the Hawaii Islands. And I invite you to find your best way to create sustainable food choices that are supportive of the environment. Because there's a lot of propaganda out there saying that, you know, vegetarian is the way to save the environment. And I'm a big believer on regenerative agriculture, definitely ethical animal husbandry. But regenerative agriculture as a way to improve the soil health, help with climate change, and bring empowerment back to the farmers and the people. So this is a great way to do it. And I'm so grateful for you joining me here. So enjoy your broth. Let me know what's working for you. And then, like I said, try with the different brands, how whatever brand you end up with, give it a try one-to-one, because that helps to stretch the broth so that you're not spending what seems to be a lot of money. It can get pricey, especially, it depends on how much you're drinking. Maybe you want to drink more than a cup. Maybe you want to stretch it, you know. So I like to create value and options. So definitely try out the dilution, try one-to-one, see if that's like too watery and it doesn't have enough flavor for you, then maybe do like 2/3 concentrate to 1/3 heated water, and then play with your salt, and then add some collagen in there, and then see what happens in your afternoon for your afternoon energy as well as your afternoon clarity. All right. Thanks so much. I'm really glad that you're here. If you have any questions, please let me know. If you learned anything, please smash that like button. Subscribe if you haven't already. We'd really love your participation here at Live Yoga Channel. I'll be back on tomorrow morning, 7 a.m. Hawaii time, but I'll be leading a full traditional Hatha yoga class. So thanks so much for joining. It means the world to me. Have a beautiful day. Ahui ho. Aloha.